So, let me start by, what was the first time that you heard the track? How did you get into contact with...
Well, I did the track Eintag am Strand. I released it with Ultra for the US. Mm-hmm. And they asked me if I was interested to remix this track, and I hadn't heard it before that. So they sent me a sample, the full record. I had a listen to it. It wasn't... my first impression was, what am I going to do with this? Because it's a little bit far from what I do. I'm more into the deep house kind of thing. But then again, it was also an opportunity to remix John Legend, so you want to make that work somehow.
Yeah. Are you a fan of John Legend's work, for instance?
Yeah, for sure. I think he's a really good singer, and when you get a chance like that, you really got to take it.
He's quite buried in this particular version.
Yeah.
So, what were your immediate thoughts? Okay, I'm going to remix that track, and I'm a fan of John Legend's work.
Yeah.
Do you have an image in your mind already?
The first thing I thought was, we haven't looked at the original now, but in the original it starts with the guitar, and I thought maybe I can use this guitar a little bit, and I quite liked some parts of the vocal as well. Not everything at first listen, but I thought I'm going to give it a try, just try to get a groove going and see where it goes from there.
Yeah. And you were completely free, or did the label have any ideas as well?
Well, it's Ultra, so it does need to be something that will appeal to a lot of people. But that's also what I thought. It doesn't make any sense if you remix John Legend and you do something really difficult with it, or if you bury his voice in all the sounds, for instance.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So you're a Cubase user.
Yeah.
Yeah. Way to go, bro.
So you've always been, I believe, you've been using it for a long time.
Yeah, since 3.7, I think.
Okay. So maybe you can talk us through your build-up of the track in Cubase.
Yeah, sure.
I can imagine that it's good to see Elke work a bit, and if later on there are questions, specific questions, we can ask them. But first, let him give us a recount of the story.
I'll start out with how I started the remix. So you can see what I'm doing. So we've got the thing I originally started with was this. This bass organ we have here. I had his voice over here. And let me put that together with my drums.
I'll take my time.
Sort of how I started. I really like that bass line, and it's a different chord than the original. And the only problem I had was, let me solo the bass organ for a bit. This is how it originally sounded. I wasn't too fond of the low frequencies in this bass, so what I did is take those out. And then I went on to my Moog Voyager, and I created this bass line to go with it. And together you get this really nice groove, because they're playing a little bit different notes. So this was basically, when I started, I had this loop going on for maybe 30 seconds or something.
You changed the chords.
Yeah, because the original was, I can play the original, I think it's in, let me check. It's here somewhere. Yeah, this is what I got from John Legend, or from Benny. This is the guitar I was talking about. Keys. I didn't get inspired just by this, you know. I didn't think if I put a beat or something to this that it would work as a deeper version. The vocals though were really good, so that's why I started experimenting with this the 90s house kind of bass line, which I really like.
Okay. So after that, you had this basic setup.
Yeah, I had this 30. Maybe it was like 30 seconds, 1 minute. And send it off to a couple of people, also send it to Ultra to see if they were feeling it. And they actually really liked it, and they said, you know, let's go on with this. And to be honest, the vocal, I really liked it, but there in the beginning there were some parts I wasn't sure about. So my original idea was to use parts of the vocal and maybe loop that or something. But Ultra was really keen on getting the whole vocal in there. And it
Maybe that's their deal with John Lennon.
That's the thing, yeah. And after a while, you know, I could. Sometimes you have to make these compromises, and then you see that it actually works in the full track. And once I started doing that, started using the whole vocal, I was really fond of it.
Okay, what additions did you make afterwards?
Let me see. Well, there's a couple of synths that are important in this track as well. This is one of them. The track is mostly based on this drum loop, and I do use a lot of like transition effects here and there. So you've got this synth that came from I think this is from my Dave Smith Mofo. Then we have the important track, part of the track, which is, let me see here, I think. I can't even feel the drum. No, here. Oh, everybody's going to the floor. Maybe I don't want to dance anymore. Don't want to dance anymore. How can you dance away? Here is the is these synths that come on top of the I'll play them one by one so you get an idea of what they're all playing the same melody, which is these chords. Actually, normally I don't do that much. It's more of a trance thing, I think. I don't usually layer sounds that often, but it wasn't like if I mute some of these, it wasn't sounding strong enough. This one is very, very much in the background. You don't really hear it that much. The other one, this one's quite important. What I wanted was to give it this sort of club feel as well, so when you go to the break, it really builds off and then it hits back in with just the bass line and a couple of elements. I'll play that for you. Vocal So you could hear, I think it was here, some elements just before it hits the break. So what I like to do very often is I use guitar rig a lot, and then I think this is a bounce actually, this is a wave file, I think, yeah. Don't know if it's, this is probably the original, let me check.
You put this through guitar rig.
Yeah, guitar rig is great for that. It does, you can put as many effects in chain if you want and create this really cool sequence. I use this one a lot too.